from the St. Jakob Park, the home of FC Basel. This is Peter Drury, and next to me providing insights will be Jim Beglin.
Glad to be here, Peter, and I'm ready to rumble.
Sides who have already met once this season. So, Jim, who would you identify as the key man in this fixture?
That's a toughie, but I'll go for big Giorgio Chiellini. He may not go about his business in the most stylish fashion, but he's a dogged, committed competitor who won't back down without a fight. He's also a very big threat when it comes to set plays.
Yeah, the scourge of so many strikers. And he's there to cut it out. He's got rid of that. Higuain looks to slip it through. Higuain looking to get on the end of this. Chance to shoot. That is wayward.
Well, I would say the goalkeeper merits praise for taking charge then. He snuffed out the threat and he put pressure on. Well, he really should have made it 1-0 there. He had both the time and space to give his team the ideal start. Now he's got to put it behind him.
Well, they would seem to be trying to expose the centre of that defence to runners.
It makes for some terrific movement.
It does, and they may be hit on the break because obviously it requires numbers forward to stretch them out.
Alexandro floats one over. Done very well to intervene. For a moment you felt that was going somewhere, but they'll have to go again. Some good work on the right flank. Now, what's next?
Listen, I think you can understand at times that the pace of the game pressures players into split-second decisions, and sometimes they just make the wrong one, and I think he would have been better placing that.
Bale. A glorious footwork.
chances from distance were never really that good, and you'd always favour the keeper in that instance.
Puts it towards the front. Good running with the ball. Can they build on it? And he's there to make a great save.
I can only add that he's got reflexes that are in perfect working order, Peter. That was very good to watch.
Upfield, and it's Bale. Cut out in the nick of time. The ball's come loose, and the chase is on. Alexandro tries to get it forward quickly. It's a loose ball. Vertonghen cuts it out. It's loose. Who's getting there? Catches it safely. Spreads it wide. Has gone out. Lacazette demanding a quick ball here. We hit half time, and engrossing half, but we're still where we started, 0-0. And we're off again. 0-0 then, and we're back on the way. Tries a through ball, Lacazette. Overhits and out of play. Vertonghen. It's going to be another throw. Juventus, whose last result owes so much to the astuteness of their manager.
Peter, he was lauded by the media, and quite rightly too. I think what he did was clever and decisive, and it just goes to show how tactically astute he is.
He's got away with one there. Aimed long and direct. Long ball, but not especially accurate. Pops it upfield. Forward it goes. He's had a shot! Goes direct to the front line. The ball needed to be better there. It's a wasted chance.
This defence is wary about opposition pace.
So they're just not getting too tight?
Yeah, they know that if they step up, their keeper could get a whole lot busier.
Kedekesh. Yeah, he's fouled him there. Oh, Lacazette. The referee's awarded a free kick. Well, that looks like a final warning. Still no card. Side of his game.
Well, they say that your front lads should be that first line of stopping the opposition, and I think he's taken it to another level with his desire to get back and help everyone out.
Looks like a good ball through. He's going to have to tune his rangefinder before the next one. Brings it forward. Chiellini, very foot. Oh, he's going to be pulled back for that one. That's going to be a booking. Kick.
Just a few more moments for them to hang on. Referee looks at his watch and blows his whistle. Terrific contest. It really might have tipped either way. The margins were tiny. Just a goal in it. That was it.
After that solitary second half goal, they did what all good teams do and protected their lead.
So before we go, many thanks to Jim Beglin for his input, and from us both, good afternoon.